Most living things on Earth need oxygen to survive, even plants, and they all use that oxygen in roughly the same way. But recently, scientists discovered a species of bacteria that uses oxygen totally differently from every other organism on Earth. Hi, I'm Cameron, and this is Minute Earth. Oxygen atoms are very good at sticking to electrons. In fact, the way we get energy from food, called respiration, involves combining the oxygen we breathe with hydrogen and electrons. But they aren't simply combined. Instead, electrons are pulled off of molecules from food and hot potatoed along a chain of proteins. When the electrons arrive at the oxygen atoms, they combine with hydrogen and oxygen to become water, generating the energy organisms need to survive in the process. Of course, there are places on Earth without oxygen, and organisms that live in those places have evolved to use elements other than oxygen to accept electrons. But oxygen allows organisms to generate more energy. Which brings us back to those special organisms I mentioned earlier, cable bacteria. Cable bacteria live in mucky sediment at the bottom of shallow lakes where they feed on hydrogen sulfide. There's no oxygen in this muck. There is, however, oxygen at the surface of the muck, roughly a centimeter away from where the cable bacteria feed. But cable bacteria are, well, bacteria, so oxygen might as well be a world away. However, cable bacteria have a creative solution to this problem, and it's literally in their name. They form a cable-like conga line of thousands of cells that extends upward from their food source to the surface. The cells at the base of the conga line take in food and pass electrons through a chain of proteins, much like other organisms do. But to get to oxygen, those electrons are routed onto little biological wires that run through a shared membrane surrounding all of the cells in the conga line. That way, the electrons are brought all the way up to the surface where oxygen is waiting to stick to them, ultimately stretching that final step of respiration. In most other organisms, this usually occurs on the scale of nanometers within a single cell, but cable bacteria stretch that step out to a distance that spans the length of over 10,000 cells. Cable bacteria are literally live wires, which makes them fascinating to scientists. Many bacteria live in environments without oxygen, and many live in environments with it, so neither of those things are out of the ordinary. But nothing else we know about lives as an electric snorkel in order to benefit from oxygen in an environment where no other bacteria have access to it. And the fact that we've only found out about these bacteria about a decade ago makes me wonder, what other strange forms of life are out there, right under our noses? We made this video in collaboration with the Center for Electromicrobiology at Aarhus University, which is made up of the fascinated scientists I mentioned a minute ago, who have made it their mission to learn as much as they can about cable bacteria. Although you can see cable bacteria with the naked eye, they were only discovered in 2012 in Denmark when researchers plugged chemical sensors into the sea. Today, the Center for Electromicrobiology brings together geochemists, molecular biologists, physicists, and ecologists to find out all sorts of cool things about cable bacteria, like how they make their own electric wires from proteins that could one day replace the toxic wires in our smartphones, or even that their presence in a rice plantation can reduce its methane emissions by more than 90%. In other words, we are just now plugging into the fascinating world of cable bacteria.